What's Tesla's next car going to be? After all, it's already made a saloon, an MPV, an SUV, a pickup truck, and a supercar. Well, Elon Musk confirmed that Tesla is about to build his cheapest new car ever, and it will be packed with loads of futuristic battery tech that you've never seen on an electric car before. I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about it and show you exclusive pictures of what this new Tesla could look like. Anyway, I'm Matt Watson, and you're watching CarWow. Before I tell you about this new car, we have to go back to 2008 and check out the very first Tesla ever made. It was called the Roadster, and it was a small convertible sports car. Now, it wasn't a huge success. Tesla only sold about 2,500 of them, but it taught Tesla a lot about how to build electric cars, and it put all this knowledge into the Model S that came out in 2012. This electric saloon blew everyone away with its futuristic design, huge touchscreen, and epic performance. And just when the world had started to calm down, the Model X came out in 2015. That car really was a bolt from the blue. It was a seven-seater that was quicker than some supercars, and you can't forget about those falcon wing doors, can you? Anyway, after the Model X came the Model 3 saloon in 2017, and then the Model Y crossover went on sale in 2020. Well, in the US anyway. We're still waiting to get the car in the United Kingdom. Can you spot a pan here? Well, on the most part, Teslas are getting smaller and cheaper as the years go by. And Tesla has confirmed that its next car will be the smallest and cheapest one it's ever made. Imagine something like a Volkswagen ID.3 and you'd be right on track. But why is Tesla making a hatchback? Well, it's all to do with how much electric cars cost to build. When the first Roadster came out in 2008, the components for electric cars were really, really expensive. The motor, the batteries, and the charging systems all cost an absolute fortune because so few companies were actually building them. And that meant Tesla had to sell its cars for a lot of money in order to stay in business. But since then, the cost of all these parts has dropped massively. So Tesla can start selling smaller, cheaper electric cars without worrying about losing too much money. Loads of car makers are doing this. Take Mercedes. Its first electric car was the EQC, which is a big, luxurious SUV. But now you can get an EQA, which is a smaller, cheaper crossover. And Audi's been at it too. Its first mass-produced EV was the e-tron, which was also a big, posh SUV. But it's getting ready to launch the new Q4 e-tron. That's a smaller and cheaper SUV, crossover thingy. You get the idea. Anyhow, back to the Tesla. The first Roadster cost around £60,000, and for that you got a 53 kilowatt hour battery and around 230 miles of range. Nowadays, a Renault Zoe comes with a 52 kilowatt hour battery for less than £30,000. And that car has a 245 mile range. So you get more range than the Tesla for less than half the price. And that's a pretty huge improvement in 13 years. But this new Tesla isn't just going to use the same parts as everyone else. It's going to have a new kind of battery that's more powerful, safer, and cheaper. So it's a win-win-win scenario. These batteries are called tabless batteries, and they use a different kind of connector to join up all their individual cells. Most electric car batteries use a pair of metal tabs attached to each cell to do this. But these tabs can restrict the flow of electricity, and they sometimes get very, very hot. And in really extreme cases, they can actually catch fire, which is not good. But Tesla's new batteries don't use tabs at all, hence tabless. This means they can store and release more electrical energy with less risk of them overheating. And it also makes them about 35% smaller. Tesla says its new tabless cells will help boost its car's range by 16% per kilowatt hour of battery capacity. So that means for every 100 miles a Tesla can now do, it should be able to do 160 miles in future using these new tabless batteries. So what does that mean for the new car? Well, Elon Musk has already confirmed that the new Tesla hatchback is going to cost $25,000, which is around £18,000. That's less than half the price of the cheapest Model 3 you can buy right now. That car is a standard range plus. It costs £44,000 and has a 278 mile range. Anyway, back to the new Tesla. Because it's going to cost half as much as the Model 3, you'd expect it to have half the battery capacity. But because this new tabless technology lets Tesla squeeze out an extra 16% more range from each kilowatt hour, this new car should have at least 160 miles of range. Now, to put that into perspective, one of the cheapest new electric cars you can buy right now is the Fiat 500 Electric. The entry-level version costs £23,000 and it has just 115 miles of range. That means this new Tesla will cost £5,000 less than the Fiat and could have almost 30% more range. But Tesla's also found a totally new way to fit this battery to its cars, which should make its cars lighter, cheaper, and roomier inside. Most electric cars store their batteries under the floor. This is why there's lots of electric SUVs around. They're taller than normal cars, so they have lots of space underneath their floors that you can fill with batteries. You can't do this so easily if the car is really small or low to the ground, like in the Audi e-tron GT, for example. That car is so low that Audi had to cut holes in the battery to make space for passengers' feet. They call them foot garages, apparently. Now, if you want to see my full in-depth video review of the Audi e-tron GT, click on the pop-out banner up there. Go check it out. Anyway, Tesla's found a way to get around this for its new hatchback using a kind of structural battery. This is where the battery actually forms an integral part of the car's chassis. It's just like the way a Formula One car's engine holds the suspension to the rest of the car, or the way fuel tanks in an aeroplane add strength to its wings. This helps make the car lighter and stronger because the batteries are doing some of the work to support the car's chassis, not the other way around. And this construction method should make the cars cheaper to build too, because they'll have fewer parts. And I'm not just talking about a handful of bits here and there. Tesla says its new structural batteries will have 370 fewer parts than a normal battery would. So they'll be quicker to build and use fewer materials to make. This means they'll cost less when they go on sale and they'll be lighter than a similar sized normal electric car. Tesla reckons this new tech will make its new car 10% lighter than a conventional electric car of the same size. This could boost the new Tesla's range by another 14%, from around 160 miles to more like 180 miles. Now that's great and all, but what does that mean for performance? Well, the lighter a car is, the quicker it can accelerate because its motor or engine has less mass to move. This means the new Tesla hatchback will probably only have one electric motor to keep the costs down, though that doesn't mean it'll be slow. The current Model 3 Standard Range Plus only has one electric motor, but it'll do 0 to 60 in 5.3 seconds. So it's possible that this new Tesla hatchback with its lighter chassis and new high-tech batteries could be even quicker than that, even if it uses the same motor as the entry-level Model 3. Like that car, you'll be able to get different versions of this new Tesla. Elon's already confirmed that there'll be a fully autonomous version along at some point. This will use an upgraded version of the full self-driving tech that Tesla's testing out right now. This upgrade costs just over £7,000 at the moment, but the price could come down by the time this new little hatchback goes on sale. But, and there's always a but, all this new technology is going to take some time to get right, and Tesla has said the new car won't be ready until 2023 at the earliest. But Tesla being Tesla, you know they're going to show sneak previews and start teasing this new car much earlier than that. Like it did with the new Roadster and the Cybertruck. But what if you can't wait for this new car to come along? Well, here are some exclusive renders what the new Tesla hatchback could look like. For starters, it'll be smaller than the Model 3 and the Model Y, but you'll still immediately recognise it as a Tesla. It'll get a smaller front end to those cars with swooping headlights and no ugly fake grille. It won't have the same sloping roofline as a Model 3, but it'll be lower and sleeker than a Model Y. And it'll probably have similar brake lights to most of today's Teslas. But the big question is, what's this car going to be called? Well, that's anybody's guess. Today's Teslas are called the S, 3, X and Y, because it sort of spells sexy and they couldn't get the Model E, so they had to call it the Model 3. Anyway, the Cybertruck and the Roadster don't fit in with the sexy naming convention. So who knows what this new hatchback will be called? What do you think it should be called, actually? And would you buy it over a Volkswagen ID3? Let me know in the comments. Be interesting to know your thoughts. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Also, comment below any kind of other videos you'd like us to do. If you want to watch some more videos, click on the windows there.